Thank you very much for joining us in the middle of this hectic time. Congratulations on joining politics.
Thank you.
From a successful, hugely successful career, you've taken a big leap. Obviously disillusioned with the kind of politics we have in India. So what is your, we want to know your, where you stand in terms of how are you different from what, what's your opinion of Modi, Rahul and the Mahagathbandhan?
Modi is a no. Modi is a no-no. Look, see, he's very dramatic.
This is coming from an actor.
He's insulting an actor. Yeah, I mean, what is the intent of an actor is also there. No, look at his language now. No, why is he saying Abdullah and Mufti? Why is he saying there is no Hindu terrorism? Why is he using Pulwama? Why is he not talking about his report card? There are 5 million jobs which has come down. They say, why is he on a denial mode? Why is he on that rhetoric? Why is he scolding? That is very unbecoming of a leader of a prime minister. I would rather ask him, you know, this is what I tried. This is where I failed. This is where we need to go. This is how the country has to go. No. Mm-hmm. Pulwama also, it is so inherent. It is against Muslims, against minorities, which is not right. And his man, he says, Modi Sena. The point is, he has choosing to be silent on certain issues, has emboldened a narrative, which is not right. Which is not right. I am not feeling secular with him when he is talking.
And Rahul?
See, Rahul has to revive his party. We yet have to see, because he has not delivered or things like that. And he is with somebody. So the people in Congress are a burden to Congress. That is what he is. He is trying to look at Bengaluru Central. Look at them. They are also not trying to put their foot down. They are also actually polarizing, no? Without the permission, they say, we are a Muslims party, we are a Christian party. But what have they done? The whole country, I feel, is voting with fear. All Hindus are not Hindutvas. But the narrative is that if the minority comes, there is no choice. We have to first realize that these two are not the alternatives. We need to realize not a political party. Every citizen need to understand who is the candidate who is representing. Let him join to any political party. That way, it is not the party which is important. It is that 500 odd candidates we choose. And we, especially the learned people who don't vote, should realize 30% of vote is from the poor. And that is bought. There is no conscious voting there. And these guys are living on it. The differences of winning margins. So I think those who don't vote should realize that they are also responsible for where this country is. And those who have read and who's looking this as a kabaddi match, you know, taking sides, is also wrong. As a note, as an individual, you have to stand back, see the issues, see who's talking sense. It is not important whether it is from your community, from the party you like. We should understand what we like certain things, no? So that narrative, I think, voices like me, voices individual, voices like me, see, it is not about winning. We should realize no candidate, no party wins. If you choose a wrong candidate, people lose. If you choose a right candidate, people win. That is what they should know. Right. And somebody has to continuously talk. If they're going to continue, one voice has to come out. And it's a very strong voice. I mean, it is somebody, somewhere along the way, I'll make sense, no? And that is more important.